Real YouTubist fight against Regirock. Regirock is surprisingly strong. Hello. It's me, guy who can't figure out OBS. Anyway, today we're talking about my losers round 2 match against Marcus Sponholz, I believe it's pronounced. For those of you who are unaware, this is the match right after I was sent into the loser's bracket. I have that matchup as well. And the match in the winner's side was like a little bit, I don't want to say questionable, but there was a little bit, there was a lot of variance involved. I got critical hit in both games to lose. And I may have lost anyway, but it was definitely like, I was definitely a little bit shaken going in. So, yeah, it was definitely a rough way to lose. And now I'm up against a team that I'm honestly pretty worried about because in the one hand, it looks very similar to the team we fought in round one. But the big noticeable difference here is that there's a Regirock. And like Regirock is a pretty difficult matchup for Colossal because the thing about Regirock is you can't surf to activate Colossal's weakness policy without activating Regirock's weakness policy. And like all my Pokemon can hit it for super effective damage, but it becomes extremely bulky, and the opponent has screens Grimmsnarl. So, so it's actually like a pretty scary Pokemon overall. The rest of the team isn't that threatening, but there's also a Landorus T here. So I am deciding just to do my default mode because like the Pokemon I'm not bringing, Incineroar and Moltres, like it's not like they have a better matchup versus Regirock. You know, this is definitely going to be a Colossal game. And I have some tools as well. Like I have Will-O-Wisp Dragapult. I have Urshifu, which always crits and crit through Curse Defense Boosts. I'm definitely worried. So I see Grimmsnarl and Regirock at turn one here, and I'm thinking, okay, there's no way I'm surfing, right? My objective right now is to burn this Regirock and try and slow play the game, and then, like, yeah, basically try and burn the Regirock to stop the damage output, and then from there I want to, stall out the Dynamax of the Regirock and then try and win in the late game with Urshifu critting through the defense boost because it does, like, 60 to 75%. I make a mistake right away here. I switch into Urshifu when really what I should be doing is switching into Rillaboom. I just forgot that, like, yeah, I honestly just, like spaced out and forgot that my Colossal's slower than Grimmsnarl most likely. And so if we both switch, which is what ends up happening, then I'll switch second and therefore get my terrain up. So you can see I'm, like, considering it. I'm actually considering maxing here. Because I think they're going to activate weakness policy one way or another, but, thinking about it, I think, yeah, that's part of the reasons I ran into time. Because I'm thinking about just getting Vocalith down immediately, because they're going to activate my weakness policy for me, and Regirock is faster, but yeah, in the end I switched to Urshifu. If this was a Rillaboom switch, it would have been better. This, you'll see how the turn plays out, but yeah. I'll skip ahead here. They switch into Feeny, so I can no longer burn the Regirock, but if I switch into Rillaboom here, just checking my camera periodically, because it's been freezing today. If this had been a switch into Rillaboom, then I could have burned the Regirock, and I would have been immediately in a really, really strong position. So it's Urshifu switch in, and they're going to max here. I'm just going to skip the animation. They do max the Regirock, which is good. I wasn't that worried about max Regirock, and, like, as long as it didn't have boosts. I was confident I could stall it. So, I go for Will-O-Wisp, but it fails, unfortunately. And they're going to go for Hailstorm, actually. So one of their moves is Ice Punch. I believe it was Ice Rock. Ice Punch, Rock Slide, Drain Punch, Curse, I believe is the set. But my Dragapult's so bulky that, like, I'm not going down to that, thankfully. So, yeah, Dragapult survives because of the safety goggles. I don't have to worry about Hail Chip here. So, I do take a bit in my Urshifu. I lose my Focus Sash. This turn would have gone so much better if it had been Rillaboom switching in there instead of Urshifu because Grassy Terrain would have been up. I would have been healing. The Regirock would have been burned. My Dragapult would have been healthier. And I would have immediately had the pressure on the Feeny versus this turn. I don't really pressure anything. I'm not really sure why I switched into Urshifu. Yeah, I think I was afraid of Curse and wanted to pressure it into Dynamaxing, but yeah. You can see here, I'm not sure, I'm probably going to get one attack off with my Dragapult, so I'm not sure if I want to go for a Light Screen, which will help versus the Feeny, or if I want to go for a Will-O-Wisp into the Regirock, but I do just have to Will-O-Wisp the Regirock and now bring in my Rillaboom. Again, this could have been done last turn, so that was inefficient. Checking camera right. Skipping. Rillaboom switches in. I'm going to get Grassy Terrain up. And they go for... I do connect, that's really big. Regirock, if I miss here, I'm probably in pretty bad shape, but since I connect him, it's not that bad. They're going to go for a Moonblast into my, I believe, Rillaboom. Yeah, Rillaboom takes a Moonblast here, and then they go for Hailstorm again, this time into the Dragapult, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, just finishing off Dragapult, so... I do lose Dragapult, but I still get the burn up, and, like, as you can see, Tapu Fini Moonblast isn't doing very much. There's a lot of, like, passive damage between turns. I'm just going to skip it if that's cool with everybody. Hail, Grassy Terrain, Hail, Burn. Basically, Regirock's taking a little bit of chip each turn. I this turn go into Colossal because basically what I'm setting up for is what you're about to witness, which is I'm going to go Colossal this turn, and I'm going to protect you turn. And what that does is that, like, they can actually put my weakness policy if they want, but basically what I want to have happen is at the end of Dynamax, to be able to boost up my Colossal, like, without too much fear. Especially because this Regirock is burned, so it's not, like, Regirock is strong with weakness policy, but I'm not activating the weakness policy for it, so, yeah. I'm just going to protect my Colossal here and U-turn into the Regirock. The Feeny could switch out if it wants, but, yeah, we'll have to wait and see. But I actually think that this position is pretty good for me, because I burned the Regirock and they're almost out of Dynamax, and, like, because Regirock has burned, like, they don't have that much, and they've already Dynamaxed, they shouldn't have a really easy time dealing with my Colossal, and they have bulky Feeny and Grimmsnarl as, like, some of their last mons. So, yeah. Grimmsnarl switches in here, a good switch, to be sure. Yeah. I'm just going to regular protect here. If they activate my weakness policy through protect, I can consider not, like, it's not going to do that much damage, and I can consider not going for, I could consider not going for the side Aqua Jet immediately, at least. But yeah, I'm going to switch out here. I'm going to go into my Urshifu. The sash is already broken, because I switched it in turn one foolishly, so I don't even have to worry about, like, losing the sash here. And they just go for a max Knuckle, if I'm not much mistaken. They're trying to raise their attack stat so that they can do more damage with, well, they're out of max, but you can see it's not a very strong move at all, and Urshifu is still really healthy. So even though they're at plus one, like, they're close to being in range of Surging Strikes. I'm just gonna passive damage. It takes the passive damage is like a full minute, every single turn, and they undo their Dynamax. So now I'm in a position where I can just go for Vogelith. I have full HP Colossal up. I've got the burn on the Regirock, and I am chipping away at the Regirock gradually. So yeah, it's just gonna be an Aqua Jet and side Aqua Jet and Vogelith here for me. I'm really not that worried about the Regirock anymore because, I can KO with Max Grass probably at plus two. I'm actually not even sure how much it does, but also Surging Strikes is always going to do like 60 to 75% if I'm not much mistaken. I can run the calc on that again, but it does a lot of damage and it curves through defense boost. So, yeah, I just need to make sure that in the end game I preserve my Urshifu to win. I'm gonna skip ahead here. I do Gigantamax. So we're skipping the animation. Colossal gets big. They're gonna go for a Light Screen here if I'm not much mistaken. Aqua Jet comes out into my Colossal, activates, it does a lot of damage as you can see, but, it also puts me in such a good position, and I do still have Rillaboom in the back, so once I get rid of this Grimmsnarl, they have two Pokemon left to lose to, Rillaboom, with Feeny and, Regirock. Light Screen comes out, that's smart. I mean, you have to stop Colossal's damage output somehow, so, I agree with that play. I do not have a Light Screen up this game either, so Vogelith comes out, and, I'm gonna do some big damage to the Grimmsnarl. I believe it puts it in range. I think that's a range of Hail plus Vogelith, but I'm not entirely sure. There's one turn of Hail left. And then they're going to go for, I think, a Drain Punch here. Yeah, Drain Punch comes out. It is plus one, but it's also burned. So, yeah, it's, like, doing nothing. I mean, not nothing, but it's not doing very much. We will watch the passive damage this turn just to see if the Grimmsnarl goes down, because now Vogelith is in play. So Colossal takes some chip here. Urshifu takes some chip. That will be healed off with the grassy terrain. Grimmsnarl takes a little bit of chip. That's probably, if that's in range, it's going to be in range by, like, one HP. Grassy terrain. Urshifu, Grassy Terrain, Vogelith. No, not in range. Okay, cool. But this isn't even a bad position for me, because what I can do here is that I can just, like, Regirock, I need gone at some point, and it, like I mentioned, it's getting close to being in range of Surging Strikes, so since the Grimmsnarl doesn't really threaten me here, I can actually double the Regirock if I want, and take it out that way, because I'm not sure how much Max Overgrowth is going to do, but, yeah, by going for Max Vogelith and Surging Strikes both into the Regirock, on the one hand, I leave myself open to Grimmsnarl potentially going for, like, a Spirit Break and KOing my Urshifu, which would be bad. However, it would still be, a 1 versus 2, because Grimmsnarl goes down at the end of next turn, and, or at the end of this turn, excuse me, and I would have one turn of max, and I would have Fake Out Pressure. So I thought that the situation was favorable for me regardless, like, even in a worst-case scenario, so by doubling the Regirock here, like, maybe Feeny can switch into the Vogelith, but it's not gonna be able to take Vogelith plus, Vogelith Chip plus Surging Strikes, all three. They go for Scary Face, actually, which is their fourth move. It's to Reflect Light Screen, Scary Face, and Spirit Break. But I just go for Vogelith. I didn't go for Grass here, because in case they switched into, like, I don't know, in case there was, like, something that wanted to switch in, Vogelith is probably my strongest move in general. Maybe they had Cortana. I think they have Cortana on their team, right? Yeah, so maybe just in case Cortana switched in, like, this would still do the most damage possible, and would definitely get me the KO. Maybe Grass is better there, actually. I don't know. I think it depends on what I think is in the back, but I just wanted to use, like, my strongest move in general. Grassy Terrain comes out, and they're going to faint to the Vogelith. So now they have one turn left of, just Cortana. Okay, yeah, then I like the Vogelith there. Because I needed to get a KO that turn. I don't think Cortana takes this attack super well, but I could be wrong. But yeah, now this game is pretty much over because I can just go from Max Flare to the Kartana, which is Assault Vest, and pick up the KO, and then Rillaboom will beat Feeny in a 1v1, even if Feeny could beat Colossal, which I don't think happens very easily, and I still have Vocalith up. So I'm just going to go from Max Flare into Kartana here, and this should be... Is it a switch? Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I don't have to switch in here, but it doesn't hurt either. Really, Urshifu's not doing anything at this point. And losing Urshifu for no reason can be bad. Like, I think that maybe switching Rillaboom in here is kind of not great, because, like, it kind of opens me up losing to... Excuse me, losing to bad luck, but, yeah, we'll see. Urshifu's gonna switch here. Kartana is really pinned, because even though I'm only at +3, I'm still... Or +4, I'm still way faster than Kartana. I'm even faster than, like, Dragapult at this point, I think, because I'm 3x speed, so... Yeah, Grassy Terrain goes up, which is also going to boost up my Solar Beam and provide healing for the next few turns. And I just take out Kartana here. Yeah, Kartana goes down. And they never got Reflect up either, so Rillaboom is even stronger. But yeah, I don't think Feeny ever should beat Rillaboom and Sun. Not Assault this bulky Rillaboom when the Grassy Terrain is up. I mean, it's possible because if they go for Mighty Water, and as you can see here, it doesn't do too much damage to either of my Pokemon, but it does drop accuracy on Rillaboom. And because of that, I don't really want to mess around with this, so... oh yeah, I go back to +6, that's funny, because they scary faced me. Checking camera. Okay, camera works. Vocalith comes out. Vocalith and Grassy Terrain kind of work, like, against each other sometimes, but I think it's still okay. Yeah. Although I do lose a lot of chip damage here, because between the leftovers and the Grassy Terrain. Yeah, these slower games, it's, like, so hard to keep your focus for the whole time, you know? Because there's, like, so much just dead time in between turns. That was the last turn of my max, so I D-max here. Or not D-Max, on D-Max, I guess. I just click Solar Beam and switch into Urshifu here because I did just get my accuracy dropped, and at this point I'm not trying to lose, like, because, you know, I hit Solar Beam, it doesn't KO, they Muddy Water, they KO Colossal on a crit, and they can drop my accuracy, and then I never hit a move for the rest of the game. I don't want that to happen, so I'm just gonna switch here. Taking a while to think about it. I go into Urshifu. They go for a Protect, I think. Yeah, they go for Protect. I mean... They're stalling out Sun Turn, so yeah, that's, like, better than nothing. I go for Solar Beam, it doesn't do anything because they Protect, and then passive damage, blah, 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 passive damage. You can see how much dead time there is. And then next turn, I'm just going to go for Solar Beam Close Combat and hope that it KOs. I think the Vocalith ended, so I do have to be careful, but this is still Grassy Terrain boosted, +2 Colossal. So even though it doesn't... Oh, it just KOs, never mind. Did I crit? Okay, it's just super strong, never mind. Okay, I think I always underestimate how much that's going to do, because I had Light Screen up. So yeah, that's game one. Skipping ahead to game two. I'm going to do the same thing again, except maybe I'll play a little smarter, but they actually switched the leads. They go Feeny and Grimmsnarl, which, if you remember, is the same lead that they, that I fought against in the winner side round one. So, I'm having a little bit of indecision as to what to do here, I think. I can go for Surf, of course, I can go for Light Screen, I can go for Light Screen and Max, which is what I do. Do I do that? Yeah, I just Light Screen to Max, hoping that they go for Max Geyser to activate Colossal's Weakness Policy, and therefore I'll get some damage off. But instead what happens, skipping, is they actually don't Max here. So I'm the first one and only one to Max. Colossal gets his Dynamax up. I get a Light Screen up. But unfortunately what happens here is, bang, Dragapult goes for Light Screen. They go for Light Screen as well, so I'm not doing that much damage at all. Which is not great. Light Screen is really annoying for me, although the Vocalith helps to kind of mitigate that a little bit. But I do get my own Light Screen up, so... I don't know how this Tapu Fini is trained, but it goes from Moonblast here into my Dragapult. Like, which makes sense. Dragapult was a real problem last game. And it does... Well, which actually Oko's me. And you might be thinking, oh, Wolf, like, that did a lot of damage. But it was a critical hit. So I'm actually just... Oh, well, camera froze anyway. Okay. Oh, man. Okay, cool. I'm back. Okay, let's just check the... Let's go over here. Okay. Cool. So, if we take a look at this, like, it depends a lot on the spreads here, but just for reference, like, my Dragapult's pretty bulky. And top of Feeny, like, I don't know how offensive this Feeny was. I don't think it was super offensive. But in Light Screen, like, If they have no investment, it's a 3-hit KO. And even if they're modest max, like, it's doing 68% tops, which, like, is not that much. So it's doing somewhere between, like, less, like, 40 and 70% without the crit, which, of course, is not, Which, of course, is not the case when the critical hits. So, it's a pretty bad turn for me, truthfully. Like, I don't get to surf myself. Wait, that's not right. Does this one work? I need to do this. Okay. I don't get to serve myself. I don't get an extra turn with my Dragapult, and I'm actually forced into Urshifu way earlier than I would like. And because they got Light Screen up, and I didn't like they didn't activate my policy, I do very little damage with this Vocalith. Like, it's not zero, but yeah, like it's a lot less. So the turn goes pretty poorly for me overall. And yeah, Vocalith ship is nice, and like I'm definitely doing some decent damage here, but it's not I'm not doing enough. Skipping, and I'm forced into Urshifu here because I have to side Aqua Jet, because I do need Colossal to get set up at some point, and it's, I can't Aqua Jet once Dynamax ends, so, I have to do it now, and to make the most of my max turn, so, I do go for side Aqua Jet here, and I think there's a pretty good chance Feeny protects itself, so I think what I want to do is I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, this is a pretty rough start, but, would I do that? No, I don't think so. I think I'm thinking to myself, okay, this is a pretty rough start, but maybe I can still pull it back. If Max Flare at plus two KOs the Grimmsnarl, then what I can do is KO the Grimmsnarl, and if they go for Muddy Water, then I think it's right. I think I Max Flare here. I'm pretty sure. Because I think Feeny may protect itself, so if they like try to protect Spirit Break, which I think is a pretty likely play, what I can do is, I don't think I Vocalith here. I'm pretty sure I Flare. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Vocalith would have been maybe better in this instance. This Vocalith would have been better based on what they did, but what I end up doing is I expect maybe Feeny might protect itself so it doesn't go down. So I'm going to side Aqua Jet here, activate, get all my boosts, etc., etc. And I'm hoping that Max Flare does enough damage to the Grimmsnarl to KO it, and this way, even if they Muddy Water, my Colossal like won't take that much damage, and I can still get one more turn of Max, and then go from there. So I go from Max Flare to the Grimmsnarl, but unfortunately, I mean, I probably should know this wouldn't do enough. It does, like, yeah, it's not enough damage at all. And now what my opponent will do is I'll actually go for a Moonblast into my Urshifu, which is bad, bringing it down to its Focus Sash, and then from there, oh, actually, not Focus Sash, yeah, that did less than I expected. They actually double into it with Spirit Break here, so I actually lose my Urshifu, which, like, keep in mind, if I hadn't been crit turn one, even if it's Dragapult who goes down this turn, like, even though, you know, the whole game would be different, whatever, but, like, yeah, like, I would still have Urshifu on this turn, whereas, like, now I'm forced into my last Pokemon already, so at this point, I'm like, I mean, like, I don't think I'm winning this one, you know, like, there's, like, I think there's pretty much nothing I can do, so, yeah, this goes down here, and they're gonna go into Landorus as I go into Rillaboom, and I'm running the Calc, so basically, like, they're not Assault Vest Landorus, I'm pretty sure they're Life Orb, and so I'm thinking to myself, I run the Calc, and I'm like, alright, they have Light Screen up, right, but I have Sun up. The way that I can win this is if I get Max Flare crit into the Landorus, Max Flare crit into the Landorus, will do enough damage to pick up the KO, and that's my out right now. So I'm like, okay, I can still win this. I've seen me win these. All I need is a Max Flare crit into the Landorus with Sun up with the plus two boost. I'll ignore the Light Screen and I'll pick up the KO on the Landorus, and that way I can win. So I go for Grassy Glide into the Feeny here because I think that because Max Flare plus Grassy Glide is not doing enough damage anyway. So in order to actually have a chance of winning this, I need to crit the Landorus. Yeah, at some point I'm doing Calc, because it's probably why it took me 20 seconds to decide here. And I see that that with a Max Flare crit, I can still win this. But they actually are going to play safe here. They're going to switch Feeny into Regirock, which I was a little surprised about. I didn't even consider this. And they're going to Dynamax their Landorus here. However, instead of going for, like, a Max move, they're actually just going to go for Max Guard and install at the last turn of my Max, which is a really good move, in my opinion. That was really smart, because that way I don't have the option of critting. Yeah, so that happens. I get a little bit of, this damage. What am I saying? A weakness policy activates, and then there is the end of turn passive damage and grassy terrain recovery. So Landorus takes a bit of damage, and so I'm thinking to myself, okay, I can still win this with, like, Heat Wave crit, right? Because Rillaboom beats Regirock and Rillaboom beats Tapu Fini. So if I get Heat Wave crit on the Landorus, or maybe, like Heat Wave crit plus Grassy Glide might do enough or something. I don't really know. I just doubled the Landorus here. And they actually switched Regirock out, so they're giving up their weakness policy boost, and they're going into Tapu Fini, which is interesting to me, at least. So I'm like, okay, Tapu Fini coming in. Maybe with Heat Wave crit or Heat Wave burn, like, maybe I still have a shot at this. Like, if Landorus goes down here, I think I can still win with Rillaboom, especially because now there's no item on the Regirock, and Heat Wave actually does a ton of damage, like, way more than I expected, even at plus two, because they're light screened up. And they go for Airstream into Rillaboom, so I don't get the attack off here. However, you can see that with the Life Orb and the Vocalith chip, they're actually under 50%. So they're going to get a speed boost. But Colossal, wait a second. Can Colossal win this? Because it's their last turn of Max. And Feeny's in range of of another attack at the end of this turn. There's Vocalith. Here's Vocalith. Like, Feeny's getting pretty low, you know? And Regirock doesn't have Protect. So I'm kind of wondering, like, hey, could I? Is there possible that I could still do this? Because, like, if Heatwave KOs Landorus here, then both their Mons would be in range of, like, then I could KO both Mons with Heatwave on this turn, and then I'd be in really good shape. And it's Landorus' last turn of max, but I'm calculating at this point, and Landorus, Life Orb, Earthquake, through Protect, KOs my Colossal. Or Max Quake, through Protect, KOs my Colossal. So, even though I want to just Protect and then Heatwave next turn for the win, I can't do it because, Max Quake with Life Orb always KOs Colossal through Protect, from this range. And so, unfortunately, I'm forced to Heatwave. And they're at, like, 40%, which means that within, like, two turns of Vocalith, the Heatwave, and the Life Orb, they, like, went down to, like, they did, like, 60%. So, I'm like, maybe there's a chance, but... Yeah, like, I really want to Protect here, but I just, like, I know that I'm going to faint to Max Quake through Protect because, I run the Calc. So, yeah, Feeny goes for Protect here, which is a good move. That way they won't lose both this turn either way, and Vocalith has ended. So, yeah, my only chance here is for Heatwave to KO the Landorus, whether just on its own or with a crit. But, unfortunately, Heatwave just, like, it's really not that close. Like, it lives with probably, like, 4 or 5% outside of Max, or 5% in Max. So, yeah, it really wasn't that close. And Max Quake just KOs me here, so... actually, we'll see if it's over or under 5%. I think it's under 5% here. Yeah, under 5%. Yeah, so they live with, like, 5% left, but, like, yeah, I didn't think it was going to be doing that much in the first place. So, yeah, unfortunately, we do trade there, but, yeah, I'm trying to think. Well, if I had a KO, the next turn would have been Heat Wave. Wait, hang on. Sun went up. They max guarded. I heat waved. I think Sun was going to go down at the end anyway, so I actually don't think I could have won that, even if Landorus went down, because, like, oh, wait, Regirock didn't have Protect. I think I could have won it. Never mind. I think I could have won it. It depends on if there was... Wait, hang on. I max flared. They max guarded. That's 2. Heatwave, that's 4. Then I would have to make a choice between... Yeah, it depends on a bunch of stuff there. If Heatwave KOs, then... If Heatwave KOs Landorus there, they go into Regirock. I go for Solar Beam into the Regirock. I KO it. They go for Muddy Water or they Calm Mind. They protect... it depends on, I don't know, it was complicated. I might have been able to win, but it was, yeah, like, basically, I was really behind from turn one, and I lost two of my Pokemon immediately. However, now I know which Pokemon they're going to bring. I'm totally confident because, that they had a plan that didn't involve, like, getting a critical hit turn one. So, by knowing which four Pokemon they're going to bring, I gained some really valuable information, which is that I'm positive that Feeny doesn't want to, oh wait, I'm considering something else here. Yeah, I'm considering doing Urshifu Rillaboom because, like, it matches up really good into Grimmsnarl Feeny. But just, like, I think it's too risky because if they just leave Landorus, like, I probably lose immediately because I have no way of... Like, they just Airstream turn one and then I just instantly lose. So I just can't justify it, even though I'm pretty sure that they'll lead Feeny and Grimmsnarl again. And even if they do lead Feeny and Grimmsnarl, if I end up out of position versus the Landorus, then I can, like, definitely lose. So I decided to bring the same four Pokemon again, and I'm just going to do what I did similar to my Winners Round 1 set, where I just adjusted to Game 3 based on their plan. And that's what I intend to do here as well. So they lead Feeny, Grimmsnarl again, which is, you know, quite nice for me. Well, not quite nice for me, but it's what I expected. Because what we know here is that we know what their last two Pokemon are, and this is something I kind of want to go a little bit in depth on, which is that I know... Wait, let me check the camera. Yeah, I had a feeling. I don't know, like, I'm having so much technology issues lately. But yeah, like I said, I know what their last... I know that they have Landorus T and Regirock in the back. So, like, I... Basically, long story short is I'm gonna go for Surf and Max Vocalith into the Feeny here. I watched this one, like, live with the commentary and stuff, and, like, people in the chat were saying, like, oh my god, like, what a hard read. But actually, like, to make a move... Hang on, we'll show you the turn. So it's Surf, blah, 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 Max Vocalith, blah, 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 into the Feeny. Skip ahead, watch the turn. Colossal Maxes, Dragapult uses Surf. There we go. So they actually don't go for Light Screen or anything. They double Dragapult this turn with Moonblast and Spirit Break. But I Surf myself. I get my Weakness Policy off. Unlike last game where I didn't, you know, I didn't even go for that. And I Vocalith into the Feeny, and it actually is going to pick up the KO here, as I recall. Yep, goodbye type of Feeny because there's no Light Screen. And then Grimmsnarl goes for a Spirit Break and does like 50% to Dragapult. But here's why this wasn't a hard read. Here's why this was just, like, a play that I thought covered everything. Because, like, yes, I doubled the Feeny, and, like, did it work out really well? Yeah, it absolutely worked out really, really well, right? But the reason I don't think that it's, like, a hard read or whatever is because, basically, what's the worst-case scenario there? Feeny Dynamaxes and hits Colossal with Max Water. But I've made the assumption that their back two Pokemon are, once again, Regirock and Landorus T. Like, I'm positive that it's Regirock, Landorus T. So... Let's think about what would happen if they max Feeny there. I Surf, They light screen. I vocalist into Feeny for like 30-40%. And they go for Max Geyser and KO me, right? So I lose Dragapult, or I lose Colossal. I get the rocks up. They have two turns left of their max, right? But the rain is up, and that's really crucial because I'll go into Rillaboom, and then if I can just stall at the Feeny's Dynamax, what's going to happen is at the end of Dynamax, I'll be able to get Urshifu in. And with Urshifu in, what I can do is just Surging Strikes into the whatever slots next to the Feeny, especially if I've doubled the Feeny at this point. But Surging Strikes like beats Regirock, it beats Drimmsnarl, and it beats Landorus T in the rain. Like, provided we're in the rain. And so if they max Feeny, and they can't, then they can't max Landorus, so they don't have speed control, they can't max Regirock, so they can't survive Surging Strikes. And I can just, like, cleanly win the game, especially with Vocalith's chip damage. So even though, like, it was an aggressive play, it was actually, like, it covered everything because, yeah, like, they didn't have a really counterplay to that, except for, like, they could have light screened and, you know, tried to stall me out that way, but they couldn't max Feeny. And since they couldn't max Feeny, I felt, like, pretty safe, especially because it was, I think, defensive Feeny. So Regirock could come in here, and now I'm in a bit of an awkward spot. I think maybe what I should have done this turn is maybe max grass into the Grimmsnarl and Will-O-Wisp, but I decided to switch Dragapult out into my Rillaboom and just Vocalith into the Grimmsnarl. Just like I want to take as many KOs as possible, and I want to force them into their Landorus as soon as possible. So yeah. They're thinking about it here because they have the option of maxing Regirock. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't necessarily just go for the grass Will-O-Wisp here. I think I just wanted to get the KO, and I didn't want Regirock sticking around any longer. So yeah. Skipping. Oh, shoot. Yeah, it's the end of the last game. It's Feeny faints. Yeah, okay, here's the turn. Dragapult comes back. It goes into Rillaboom. I wanted to override the terrain at some point. Getting grass to terrain up is good as well. And also just getting Rillaboom in is nice. I can knock off the weakness policy. It gives me fake out pressure. I'm still not I'm not positive if the Regirock is gonna max or not. I don't think it is, but it could. They go for light screen though, which makes sense. Like they just want to get their screen up, and that's gonna help them against Colossal for the rest of the game. They don't max Regirock. I go for Vocalith here into the Grimmsnarl because I do want to pick up KOs as soon as possible. Force them into their last Pokemon and force the last Pokemon to take chip. I actually don't even need Vocalith chip there because of the Surf plus Vocalith chip from the last turn. And now their last Pokemon is gonna have two turns of Vocalith still on it, which is Landorus T. However, they go for Curse with Regirock, which is pretty scary, in my opinion. So they're getting an attack boost. But I know that to beat Regirock, I need to save. Like, as long as I have Urshifu, then I can beat it, provided I have enough chip damage on it, which is, like, definitely a big provided, but I feel confident about that at this point. So they're going into the last Pokemon here, which is Landorus. And I know that I think what I'm thinking is that Landorus can't attack, like, can't KO both Pokemon here, like, no matter what. So I have a choice for, like, I think basically what I do here is, I can't remember if I... Okay, I U-turn the Regirock to try and get some switch momentum, and I don't really want to protect Colossal, because the thing is that, let's say I protect Colossal here, even in a best-case scenario where they Max Quake, like, I'm out of Dynamax, like, which is whatever, but if they Max Quake, then they don't get a speed boost, and if they KO Colossal, I get a free switch into Urshifu. So, what I realize is actually, like, I don't need to protect Colossal here, because even if they Max Quake, that means no speed boost, and that means that Urshifu can come in and KO the Landorus and win the game that way. I go for U-turn because, don't actually know. I don't remember why I went for U-turn here. I guess it just felt like the best option. Like, I'm intimidated. Like, I want to, like, not lose my Rillaboom if I don't have to. They're going to max here. Yeah, I mean, maybe there's a better move, but, like, it just didn't feel like Grassy Gliding into Landorus was that useful. And getting Rillaboom in the late game felt, like, pretty valuable since Regirock doesn't have Protect. So I go for Vocalith into the Landorus here. It isn't Light Screen, but I am boosted, so it actually does a ton of damage, like, way more than I expected personally. And they do go for Airstream, so... Rillaboom is gonna faint here, which isn't ideal, but, but Colossal stays alive, and they're taking a fair bit of chip damage as well between the Life Orb and the Vocalith. So they take some chip damage here, and they're gonna go for a Rock Slide onto the Colossal. So, I know this, I'm trying to remember what happens this next turn. There's the chip damage, and I don't have Sun Up because I want I think Urshifu might be important in this endgame. So I'm going to go into Urshifu here. I go into Urshifu here. And now it's kind of like what I realize is that this is a turn where a read will determine it. Because, like, let's say Landorus does not protect itself, then I can just KO it with Vocalith, right? Or with Heatwave Aqua Jet, right? But if they protect Landorus and Rock Slide, then Aqua Jet's probably not going to KO the Regirock, and, or the Landorus, and then I'm in really bad shape. So basically, like, it's like, if Landorus protects itself and I attack with Colossal, then I lose, right? And if Landorus, like, attacks and I protect either of my Pokemon, then I'll also probably lose. So I have to call correctly what's going on here, because if I get it wrong, checking camera. Yep, no surprise there. Dude, this camera, honestly, like, OBS is actual, like, garbage. I don't know what's going on. It just always freezes. So what do I do? So I'm, like, considering it. I'm considering going for Aqua Jet Heat Wave. I'm considering a bunch of different things. But what I realize is that I can at least, in the worst-case scenario, force a 2-1 by going for Protect and Surging Strikes here. Because that way, like, in the worst-case scenario, they Airstream again, and then, like, they Rock Slide, and they KO my... Like, basically, by Surging Strikes and Protecting here, I can at least force Regirock to fight a 1-1 versus Colossal and Urshifu. And I think that with Will-O-Wisp Solar Beam, I can still win that combination, because Grassy Terrain is still up, and I think that after a burn, Colossal's not in range of Rock Slide. Though I could be wrong about that, but yeah. Basically, I just had to hard read the Protect, and even if I'm wrong here, excuse me, which I turned out to be right, but even if I'm wrong about this, like, I still basically force a 2-1. So Surging Strikes goes into the Protect, or into the Max Guard, and they Rock Slide. And they do a little bit of damage to Urshifu, but I think they crit me here, so it's not super, it actually does more than you'd expect. Which I'm a little worried about, because Urshifu might have to solo this endgame, but yeah. They crit me here, kind of a drag, but whatever. Then there's some more Vocalith chips. So now they're getting really low. Let's see here, and it's their last turn of max. So at this point, I'm thinking, okay, I'm not sure Heat Wave's gonna do enough, so I'm gonna Aqua Jet and Heat Wave here. This also means that, like, I don't accidentally activate Regirock's weakness policy without burning it. So yeah, this seems like the best move to me. I get some chip damage on the Regirock, which again is pretty important because Surging Strikes is like 60-75%. So I need to get it just low enough that, like, that's enough to KO. Because Regirock also, its best move to hit Urshifu is Drain Punch. So even if I boost it, like, I don't think +3 Drain Punch while burned is even going to KO my Urshifu, because Urshifu is actually relatively physically bulky. So I was, like, a little worried about that crit, because I took more than I thought I was going to, but yeah. If I miss Heat Wave here, I'm, like, Omega. It's an eighth, I think. I have to hit Heat Wave on this Landorus. So Aqua Jet comes out, actually, is more than I expected, so I'm trying to think, like, if I knew that Aqua Jet could KO... No, I still made the right play. Yeah, I could have protected both, I guess, but I don't think that it does me any favors. So I go for Heat Wave, I do connect, and I actually burn the Regirock, which, like, I don't personally think makes that big of a difference here. It definitely, like, helps, but I think that even if I don't burn the Regirock here, Rock Slide still, Okay, I think I was correct then. Okay, so sorry, there's a couple things that I think are at play here. Number one, the Heat Wave is annoying, but the burn is annoying for my opponent, but I think that Urshifu still wins this, because as long as I hit a Will-O-Wisp and the Dragapult, or with the Dragapult and the Regirock, like, I think Urshifu should still be able to pull this one through, I'm pretty sure, with Surging Strikes. And the second thing is that, because I live the Rock Slide pretty handily here, this confirms, I think, that, like, the turn before where I went for Protecting Surging Strikes, even in a worst-case scenario where they Airstream Rock Slide and I Surging Strikes KO Landorus and then lose my Urshifu, Dragapult comes in, then I can go for Will-O-Wisp, Solar Beam, and then that's still the game, I think. Because Rock Slide didn't do as much to Colossal as I thought it would. So that's, okay, so yeah, I think that, like, even though this one, like, I burned them and that kind of lets me clean it up for free, I think that I had, like, an 85% chance to win this anyway, because I just had to hit a Will-O-Wisp in the Regirock, and then I think, barring any critical hits, I should have been fine to take it kind of regardless of what happened. So yeah, they still have a couple turns of Light Screen left, but I'm just going to go for Detect and Protect here to stall out the Grassy Terrain, I think, because that's their only form of recovery. Detect, and then go for Drain Punch, yeah. And basically, like, this endgame is pretty, like, straightforward. I just need to get them, like, basically, like, the way that I lose this is I do something stupid. And so as long as I get a little chip damage on the Regirock before I go for Surging Strikes, just to ensure that it's in range, I should be fine. So, solid the Grassy Terrain, because, yeah, like, basically at the end of the day, like, the way that I win this is I just need Urshifu to hit. I need to get, like, if Regirock's at, like, 60%, then Surging Strikes is a guaranteed KO, so I just need to get a little bit more chip damage on it before we get to that point. So, that's why I switched Urshifu out here, just because, like, what if I Surging Strikes, I miss Heat Wave, they survive, and then they crit Drain Punch me and KO me and heal a bunch of health, like, I could still lose. So, I just wanted to play to the 100% win condition, even though it's, like, a little bit more turns, but I still thought that was worth it. They go for Drain Punch this turn, into Dragapult and take some more chip damage here from the burn. And then at this point, I mean, it's pretty straightforward. I can just go for... I think maybe Surf Protect here is better. But they're in range of... they're in range of Surging Strikes at this point anyway, because I hit one Heat Wave. So I can just attack with all my Pokemon and then bring it back that way. Because Surging Strikes is really strong. Yeah, I feel like Regirock, when it gets burned, just, like, can't... I frozen. Dude, is it just, like... I don't even know what's going on with that thing. I go for Heat Wave, I connect again. This can do a lot of damage, I think. I mean, not that much damage. The Light Screen's really paying dividends, I guess. Breaking Swipe comes out. Does not very much damage. But though, considering it's Regirock and considering it has a defense boost, it did more than I expected. And Rock Slide comes out. Dragapult takes it pretty handily. And then Colossal Feint. So, yeah. And then I get to go into Urshifu. And, yeah, they have Blaster and Light Screen. So, yeah. Again, I think Surf is better here, but... Yeah, I'm actually considering it, but yeah, I don't know. I just click Surging Strikes and Breaking Swipe, because that's what's up. And Breaking Swipe comes out here. Not going to pick up the KO on the Regirock, but Surging Strikes will. So, yeah. In the end, I really don't think the burn mattered too much. I think that, like, this was going to be a pretty... Like, I think I had the end game regardless, but yeah, I'm sure it was still frustrating for my opponent. So, yeah. But yeah, that's losers round two. It was definitely really close, but I think that once I realized, like, which Pokemon they were bringing and which Pokemon they wanted to max, like... I think that it actually made it, like, a pretty clean game three for me. So even though it was a three-game set, like, I felt like I was in pretty good control of this overall. But, yeah, that's the set. I hope you enjoyed. Regirock was actually pretty difficult for my team to deal with, so I was very grateful to have beaten it. And I think Will-O-Wisp Dragapult in particular helped a lot versus this thing. I don't know if I could have beaten it without the ability to burn it. So, yeah. Anyway, I think that's all I have to say. Loser round three is next. I think that's probably my favorite set of the whole tournament, so look forward to that one. That's the Urshifu. That's the Colossal Mirror match. And yeah, thanks for watching. See you next time. Is my camera frozen? It is not. Goodbye.